Yes, very good morning, students. I am Dr. Supreet Singh, today here to discuss one of the topic from the subject of design for safety and comfort. I'll be covering up today. This will be my instructional objective for the design and safety, that you guys will be understanding the basic principle and design of automobile for the safety and comfort. That is in the case of vehicle structure, crash management, and various knowledge upon the what are the devices I can say which is using this automotive safety systems, and understanding the convenience system, understanding the comfort system in the automotive. So guys, let us start with the content. I'll be covering introduction of automotive safety and system. I'll be covering up the classifications. In this, I will be focusing upon the features of the safety of the vehicle body through the active safety devices, and for the Volvo only, which is in your syllabus. So, in the introduction, automobile safety is the study and the practice of design, construction, equipment regulation to minimize the occurrence and consequence of the automobile accidents. If the active devices are being there, for example, you can see in this figure. If you guys are can just I'm underlining the things with the pencil. That the things which are being installed, or the safety devices which are installed in the car, are in order to avoid the accidents, in order to avoid the injuries to the pedestrian, in order to avoid any crashes. So they can read signals also. They are on the car, on the road, I can say. The car has sensible features. Various sensors are being have been installed in the inside and the outside of the car in order to provide the safety to the driver, passengers, and the outside pedestrian, and to the safety to the car also. So guys, let us move to the next slide. In this classification of the automotive safety system has been classified by active automotive safety systems and passive automotive safety system. In the passive active, I can say those safety devices which are used to provide the safety to the passenger inside, and to the driver when a car is moving, in order to avoid the accident, and also safety to the pedestrian and to the car. But passive automotive safety system will work when the car will have a collision, or it will have an accident, or there will be some serious I can say collision between the two vehicle, or between some object with the car. Then passive automotive safety system will come into active and will come for the safety of the passengers and the driver. So let us start with the active safety system in the Volvo cars. The active safety system in the Volvo cars plays a very preventive role in the mitigating the crashes and accidents by providing the advance warnings, or by providing the driver with the additional assistance in the steering control of the vehicle. So let us cover this through a very I will start with a very short video with you guys. In this video, let us show you one video of the active safety devices in the Volvo. These will really help you to know that what are the active safety devices in a car. So guys, you can clearly see one car is coming. It is have lot of sensors, and it is detecting the pedestrians, the objects, and it is also calculating the speed at which some person is moving, and giving a judgment to the car that someone is there in front, in order to avoid the accidents. So you can see there was an object car in front of the driver. The car has sensed through its active safety devices. The car is sensing of cruise control. just being safe. So you can see that one, and watching something out. In that was being saved from the time. So guys, there was a little fraction control system back, which was great. So this interesting the so it is warning the driver to apply the brake immediately. See, you can see that. Dynamic stability and traction control. Let us the cruise control now. What is a cruise control? The front car was at halt, and so the cruise control led the driver to make your own car to halt, because that was a cruise control. Now see, this car was moving at some velocity, and suddenly the car in which you are sitting, that is the main car, it also started traveling at 110 velocity of the front car. See guys, this velocity has been attained due to the adaptive cruise control system in the Volvo car. It is Volvo V60 model. And see the suspension, how it is working so actively. Stabilized bar has also been installed, does not allow the movement of the chassis, but all the suspension is taking up the bumps. See how beautifully it is designed. Now automobile engineers, just keep in this in your mind that you have to work a lot upon the material study, the designing part, technology. This is toe in, toe out, cast camber angle adjustments in the Volvo V60 car. Yeah. So let us now start with the PPT. Okay, I come back over again to the PPT in which I was sharing one file with you regarding the Volvo safety features on the active device, the active safety devices, I can say. I was sharing with you. So we have just about to start that what are the various features. Okay guys, you can see in this video that integrated booster cushion, as an accident occurs, what happened, the passengers try to, if it is a passenger is having a seat belt, then also try to slide downwards, but the booster cushion does not allow to move the passenger in order to protect its legs from being get injured. Now the next part, second stage booster cushion, if the accident occurs, You can see in this I am pointing the pointer towards it, and in this you can see that when it is being hitted up, it comes to this situation, this one. In this situation, what happens that when the vehicle hit up, there is a booster cushion which get open up in this car only, and the passenger is saved. So let us do one polling session now. Please select the correct option. I am starting the polling. Which gas is there in the airbags, whether it is nitrogen or whether it is hydrogen? This is your question one, with the A, nitrogen, B, hydrogen. I started up the polling. You have 30 seconds to answer. Okay, guys. One student has answered correctly, that is the nitrogen gas in the airbags. I stopped, lock the polling, and end the polling. Then again, I come to the PPT. Next is collision warning breakout. This is also a feature in order to avoid the accident. As guys, you can see over here, there's a collision warning brake support. This so in this what happens whenever the person is traveling, and there is always a this warning type signal, this type of signal on the windscreen of the driver, that there is some car in front and you should avoid that accident by applying the brakes. And sometimes the brake pedal I can say shows the red signal, brakes is applied by its own if it is having the cruise control system. If it is having the adaptive cruise control system, then the brakes are being applied automatically. So next is the inflatable curtain airbags. Whenever some car hit from the back, then you know that the airbags are being opened, and in the front you know that the airbags are being opened. But if the car hit from the side, then we get this type of the cushion bag are being opened. Sometime it is also having throx airbag, which is inside the seat only. And in order to here you can see in this figure that in order to avoid such type of injury to the passenger or the driver, these inflatable curtain airbags are available in Volvo. So next I come to the sip bag or the side bag. This whenever there is a front collision, I can say whenever there is a front collision, then in order to avoid the accident, then what we can do that the technology is there that it sips the bag and the side airbag. The person is allowed to move in this direction, and sip airbags come outside and provide the protection to the passenger. So this was being invented in 1994, and still Volvo has the patentship for this technology, and all the car are until day 2020 using this technology. Now BSIS, blind spot information system. In this, guys, you can see that there is a warning signal in the warning signal on the I can say on the mirror, side mirror of the car. If some bike person, or I can say any of the car will move from the region which is beyond this mirror now, which is beyond this mirror, I am highlighting this because you can see this was the range where mirror can see, but this person was coming up from outside range. So a warning signal was shown to the person on the sides. So let us come to the now front structure. Whenever there is a collision, I can say there is more time for the bumpers to move back. Either what happens sometime that collision come and the passenger come outside. In order to avoid that, you can see there was a much time in this region for increasing the time period. I can say increasing the time period leads to what? Leads to the delay in the injury to the passenger. So passenger was quite safe because due to this lower cross member. Guys, so let us move forward. You have understood this. This is child safety seat. Here earlier the Volvo hasn't given before this in 2000, but in 2002 the new integrated seat, and one very good thing that it is foldable also. It will increase the space. Increase the space. It's foldable and increase the space also. Or the co-passenger sitting inside the car. Now let us come to the ROPS, the rollover protection system. What is this? This is very very interesting technology in this. What happens that whenever driver is trying to take driving the car in the muddy or the in the mountains, there is some inclination level for every Volvo. For example, the last Volvo was designed for 60 degree of inclination it can travel. So what is the technology behind that? That why, what type of safety device or the active or the passive type of safety device has been installed that car can move to such a level? What is that? So that is rollover protection device. In this I'll explain you in the next slides that it is having actuators, it is having the oil cylinders, and that actuators allow to hold the fuel inside to the oil inside that, and whenever it is required by the sensor, whenever which tire goes down, the other tire is provided with the traction movement with the ground in order to does not move the vehicle upside down or from the to providing a fatal injury to the driver or to the upside down movement of the vehicle. In order to avoid that, what is necessary that that the other tire should be in contact with the ground. So in order to provide the roll stability control, we are using this hydraulic technique. It is very very important in today's world that off-road vehicle that they should have this technology. Has designed it in 2002, that rollover protection to all the vehicles which are they designed for the off-roading, because that off-roading require much of the traction as compared to the road vehicles. So now this protection is being provided by this technology, in which it is too much safer for the passenger which is traveling inside the car, and it is designed only for the off-road. So it is quite useful for all the person who are like to use want to do off-roading, and they can use this technology of Volvo, that is the rollover protection system. So let us go through one polling session. I have created one polling in front of you, which is the technology behind the roll stability control. So you can give your answer. I have started polling A, B, and B. technology or the hydraulic? I have started that. In the Volvo, I am asking that. Yeah, correct answer. It is the roll stability is done by the hydraulic technology. B is the correct answer. Yes. Okay, student, let us move to the next slide. What is a triangular braking system? In the triangular braking system, I can make you understand very easily this concept. In this earlier, what happened that there was single all the four master cylinder were provided the braking through one common all the wheel cylinder was provided the braking through one common master cylinder. In that, what happened that if there is one leakage, then all the three of the braking system will fail. But now a triangular braking system has been developed by the Volvos in 1965. What is that? That a dual triangular braking system is developed. I can see, you can see behind this car in the bottom. These two wheels are connected together with one hose pipe, and these two are connected with one hose pipe. So the fuel stored in the master cylinder will provide the power for this separately and for this separately. If one of the air is leakage, the other will work and the car will not show any serious accident, I can say. So guys, let us move forward. The dual split triangular braking system is already covered. You can see in the diagram that diagonally the power is being provided for the braking. So this is laminated windscreen. It was designed also by Volvo and taking the royalty today till 2020. Guys, in this, what happened earlier, the hammer was being applied on the mirror or any during the crash, I can say, during a fatal accident or any serious accident, the glass were broken into small pieces. But laminated windscreen has changed the technology. It has allowed whenever there is the breakage of glass, I can say that it will be broken into laminated sheets. It will be broken to the laminated small sheets. Will not broken into small pieces which will come onto the passenger or the driver, I can say, the because that will may cause a lot of the problem to the driver while he is driving. So breakage of the glass, I can say, it will be broken to the laminated small sheets. It will not broken up into the pieces. This is also designed by Volvo. So this is the next technology, that is the collapsed steering column. Basically, in the figure, it is written wheel. I guess it is not right because collapsed steering is the column. Whenever the car face an injury, what happens that the steering comes onto the driver. It may cause a very serious injury onto the face of the driver, or maybe his neck get broken up, or sometimes if his height is short, then onto his chest of the driver, the steering wheel can cause a very serious injury. So in order to avoid that, collapsed steering column mechanism has been designed in which the steering wheels goes downward as there is an front impact onto the steering wheel, and it moves downward and does not cause any of the injury to the driver, and he or she is safe while driving. So let us move forward. What is the whiplash protection system? In the whiplash protection system, basically we are providing the protection to the neck area of the beyond the head, I can say, beneath the head. So at this point, you can say, I am taking this pencil over here. Whenever the accident occur, this seat, this part will move backward a bit due to this mechanism. So, and also there is tightening of the seat belt here, and in the whiplash system, this headrest will also be provided with some movement so that your neck should not get any serious injury or a jerk. I can say if a jerk is provided, then the neck bones may get broken. So it will move a bit backward first of all, and neck is avoided from a serious jerk, and there is a tightening of the seat belt also. So whiplash protection system is providing basically the person with a movement to the your seat towards a bit backward. So let us move towards the dynamic stability and traction control. In the dynamic stability and traction control, it is very, very good technique in this. What happens that whenever vehicle moves onto the road, the vehicle try to whenever the something come from forward, any vehicle or pedestrian or any animal come, it try to provide vehicle try to get braking. When it is in the adaptive cruisive control system, then the one of the wheels which are say outward, they will be get some braking, and the wheels which are moving inward, they will be allowed to move free, because at that they are taking the turn. So in order to avoid that serious I can say upside down movement of the vehicle, there is an adaptive cruise control system which apply the brakes only to the outer wheel. So dynamic stability and traction control is maintained. I will show a video also to that dynamic stability traction control from online to you guys. So here you can see in this there is the car is moving upon to the track only. Why it is moving onto the track? Because you can see braking is applied in this region. It is taking a turn, but these two sides are let free. So it does not allow the vehicle to do an upside down movement. So it is moving on the track only. Guys, you can clearly see in this video that the vehicle is moving onto the track due to the dynamic stability and the traction control in the Volvo. So this system makes it an I can say the active safety system device, active safety device, which is the our topic, that what are active safety devices. In the active safety devices, I can say this type of feature is quite active, in which the vehicle is not make it also increases the life of the tire. It also provide the stability to the vehicle. Thirdly, it is providing avoiding a very serious accident at that time, because at very high speed, when you take a turn towards left side, you can clearly see in this image, this vehicle can take a sharp upside down movement and would have caused a very serious injuries or made the death of the person sitting inside the car. So this movement, when your steering is being moved towards left or the right side, I can say at that time only the sensor gives the signal to the tires and to the braking system and to the traction control system then when to apply the brakes. So based upon this, I have also kept the notes for you guys in this I can say in this topic. So you can follow the lecture notes also here. I can share this with you. In this lecture notes, you can see the vehicle motion control. What are the cruise control? I have made a detailed study in this. So how it is being get controlled, how the signal is being sent from which place to where. This is having some mathematical calculation also. Those students who are interested in doing research in adaptive cruise control system, they can also do a very good study in this, because in this the drive from the camshaft to the to the lighter source, to the light detector, and further to the sensor is being done. This is a good part of study for the I can say student interested in doing cruise control studies for electronics. Also, you can consult our one of the respected teacher, Dr. Deepak Kapilaji, for this. In this study, you can follow these notes. I will be now coming again back to the same PPT, which Volvo safety features, which I was sharing with you. We have studied up to the part of the blind spot information, front structure, rollover protection, roll stability control, rollover protection. Triangular braking system we have covered. Let us move further from the traction control system to the this you can see. This you can see the dynamic stability traction control system. Side impact protection system. Guys, in the side impact protection system, whenever there is an serious, I can say this is a passive device. Whenever the accident occurs, this come into existence. In 1991, side impact protection system was designed by Volvo, and till date, they are taking the royalty from the very big brands like Mercedes. They are taking from BMW, from the Renault. They are taking the royalty for this. In this various, you can see the yellow color steel bars. I will highlight this using this pencil. You can see the yellow bars. These are the side impact protection. Whenever there is strike from like I have put an arrow over here, there is strike, and these yellow bars will provide the protection and to the protection to the car. Let us do one quiz through a polling session. Please answer the polling session. I am starting the polling. You have 30 seconds to answer. Please select the correct option. What is DSCP? Whether it is dynamic traction control or whether it is dynamic stability traction control. Yes, student have given the correct answer. That is the traction control. Stiffness is related to the option B is the correct option. Next, side impact protection system. What is side impact protection system? It is whenever the vehicle hits from the side, then at that time what happened that the vehicle hit from the side, at that time what happened that the passenger sittings at the side or the driver, they get lot of injury. So crumpler zone, like in the front the cross iron bars are there.
It's
you study the calculation part and the mathematical part of this side protection cruise control system. As I already mentioned to you that in the cruise control system that vehicle will move according to the speed which is your desirement. But in the adaptive cruise control system, what happened that the vehicle will move on itself, will apply the braking with seeing the moving of the vehicle from the right and the left. So in order to check these things, that whether the cruise controls are working or not, these things are being checked up whenever there is some vehicle come in front. So these too much of the safety features allows the driver to provide with too much of the safety. This safety to the driver is not only for the, I can say, this is not only for the Volvo, but in various smart cars this feature is available of the adaptive cruise control, and it can be provided manually also. It can be provided to you with one button also. You can select that adaptive cruise control system and you can make the vehicle to run at its own, and it will detect the drive, it will detect the it will detect the what are the features, what are the obstacles, what are the whether pedestrian is over there, and it will move its speed accordingly. I will show one video, a small video in that. Let me share my screen with you. After that we will come to adaptive cruise control system. So I guess now my screen is visible to you. I am playing one video. So you can see, due to that obstacle, the car is applying the brake on its own in order to avoid the collision. These are collision sensors. So it is a collision sensor. So here the driver is not applying the brakes, but the collision sensor is helping. Now the park assist.
Using the little blue lines, how far I still need to go before it's going to tell me to stop and change. It's probably going to ask me to go into reverse again. Yeah. Back into reverse.
Now the parking is assisting to this driver, that where you can see here in the camera, you can see here in the camera this part. He is applying his parking his car.
It
and
really, really does help getting a big car like this out of tight spaces. Again,
so it
using my indicator when we get closer to tell the car that we want to park on the right hand side. And it's now using the side-mounted sensors to scan for a gap between all these cars.
So at a very tightening space,
slot found.
He was able to park the car.
I'm going
to
tell it now that it is a parallel spot. The XC90 will do parallel and perpendicular. Selecting reverse, releasing steering. And now all I do is manage the brakes.
So see guys, the steering assistance is also not done by the driver, but
I can also
the park assist
the
pilot is helping.
You want to check the pavement for the car behind me and so forth.
So now it is applying the brake on its own.
Straighten me out, tell me when to stop.
A perfectionist, hey?
It is a perfectionist. And you'll actually see if you get out that it's parked perfectly on the against.
So this is the safety feature, that in this the parked car is not being get
too pedantic,
any accident or the injury to passenger and to the car also. Car get harmless. So it is perfectly being parked.
Right, and there we go.
Okay.
This is the safety feature. This was the safety feature which we have covered. So we will again come back to the PPT. which I was sharing with you. I have to share that file again with you people. So we were approximately about to finish this lecture. Here you have clearly understood that how these safety devices are being helping us in the parking also, and in order to provide the safety to passenger, to the driver. So we were here onto the cruise control system. So here, similarly, you can say the car is maintaining the speed of the front car. It is driving at 110. So this car is also being driven at 110. So in the adaptive cruise control system, the applying of the brakes is done automatically according to the speed. And in this, you do not have to apply the accelerate the vehicle. It will also accelerate on its own. So there are a lot of positive features in that. So guys, I would like to thank Volvo for this beautiful technology which they have given to us and changed the world with, provided too much of the safety to the human beings. I can say the life of a human being is most precious in this world. Nothing is more precious than a life of a human being. So the Volvo has given such a beautiful technology. I would like to highly appreciate the design engineers, all the engineers who are involved in this assembly and manufacturing part of this safety feature. So guys, any questions related to you, I would highly appreciate that you can email me on my email ID dr.supreet singh2333@gmail.com, or you can directly post this and your questions on the BB Collaborator software. So here we have today learned, lastly I would like to conclude that we have learned about the active devices, the passive devices, and the features of smart features of the Volvo, including the safety and the comfort. So how did you like my lecture? Please like and do share this. Thank you so much. I highly appreciate for your patience listening. Thank you. Thank you so much.